Hey, this is Aaron with Faith to Walk Ministries and bringing you a tip for devotions. A lot of people have a hard time getting into the devotions throughout the day and they want to know how to go about it. The first thing I would suggest is to pray. Ask God to have the Holy Spirit to illuminate His Word for you so that you may be able to fully understand it, fully believe it, and fully live it. And ask Him to bring you closer to Him through His Word and then thank Him for it. And that is one of the first things. There's a couple other tips I want to share with you as well. A couple other tips is, very simple put though, if you carry, now this is a premium Bible, so I do carry it in a Bible bag. Now, if I keep it in this Bible bag throughout the day, believe it or not, I will find myself not reading it as much. Now, I read it every day, but I read it more, and I'm going to tell you why. If you have it open, if you have it in this, there is this psychological thing about actually opening it. If you have your Bible on a bookcase, it is a psychological thing about, oh, you have to walk over to the bookcase and actually get it off the bookcase. So when I'm teaching on devotions for new believers, one of the first things I will say, there's a doggy toy. Squirrel. One of the first things I will say is keep your Bible open. Now, I don't suggest keeping your Bible open to the same page for days on end because, well, if you have a problem with dust, you're going to get dust in your Bible. You don't want to do that. But at least have it the place where you would have your morning coffee, morning breakfast, something like that, but have it around so it's very easily to open. And if you are in a habit of reading it every day, well, then you can keep it open throughout the day. Because what's going to happen, and if you take it to work, hey, put it in your bag, take it to work. I take mine to work. Have your Bible open, because an open Bible begs to be read. There is nothing else you have to do except put your eyes on it and read it. And you'll find yourself reading, actually, more every day. And so that's a one tip. Another tip is when because you're praying that God will help you understand it and help you learn it. So as you're going through the chapter, have a composition notebook or a notepad, anything like that, with a good pen, and just write down things that are popping up. You see a verse and you're like, oh, that's good. Write what you understand about that verse, and then write what it means to you, what God is doing with that verse in your life. And so then you will have a very, very simple Bible study going on. And if you have time, hey, it's okay to, after you pray over it, after you read it and understand, you know, what passage, what does it mean to you? And then how is God going to apply that to your life, how you feel He is? Then it's okay to pray over it again when you see those verses, to pray over those verses into your life and then consult a commentary or something, especially a passage you might not understand fully. It's okay to look at a commentary. Always remember that scriptures are inspired, commentaries are not. And that's just one of the good tips that even I, as a minister for all these years, will do. I will keep my Bible there at least on the table. This is where I sit usually to do all my studies, all my sermon message preparations, everything like that. So my Bible is ready to go. When I go to work, I take it to work. Guess what? If I leave it in this bag, it'll stay in the bag almost throughout the day. Sometimes I'll take it out for breaks and lunches. But if I take it out on my desk, I don't care who sees. And if they tell me that I can't have a Bible at work, well, then we'll just have to talk to someone else. Anyway, I had that Bible open all day long, and so I can read it anytime. And I tell you what, in my job, and this might be something that you need to do for yours, even if you're not during your break, during your lunch, if you need a certain passage, because I deal with some difficult people all day long, so I got to remember this passage right there. It's Psalm 139, verse 14, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. But that's not just for me. That's how God views all the difficult people that I have to deal with. They are fearfully and wonderfully made. They are a marvelous work. And that will put in perspective of me throughout the day as well. Hey, just a short video, just encouraging you to get into the Word of God, to read it, study it, believe it, live it, and then share it, teach it, and preach it. Hey, thank you for watching. God bless.